Differential diffusion, also known as soft inpainting, allows for much better results when retouching images. Basically, it looks at the mask on a per pixel basis as it's applied as a gradient, rather than a simple black and white mask. As you can see in this comparison here, a basic inpainting, you might have some edges of an image between the original image and the mask, whereas soft inpainting, those mask lines are completely removed, providing better results. Here's how you can do it in ComfyUI. So first up, let's load the default workflow in ComfyUI. Next, let's get the load image node. This will be the image that we'll be modifying. So here is one that I downloaded from Unsplash. I'll just open it up into the mask editor. And so today I'll be adding glasses to the subject here. So I will just mask out the appropriate area and then click Save to Node. So with soft inpainting, we're going to use three different nodes. And these are a little bit different than a basic inpainting workflow. First up will be the Gaussian blur mask. This basically softens the mask into a gradient. We'll bring in the inpaint model conditioning node, and then we'll also bring in the differential diffusion node. So here I'm just going to move these over a little bit, make some room, and bring in my model conditioning as well as my differential diffusion nodes. So for the mask, we'll pass that through to here. The kernel size is basically the size of the brush. I'm going to make this brush large, and the sigma is the softness of the brush. And then I'm going to add this convert mask to image. Now, this is completely optional, but I find it helpful to see what's going on here. And then we'll just create a small preview image of the mask. So with the checkpoint, I'll be using a realism checkpoint. And let's get all this connected. So the model, I'm going to pass it through this differential diffusion and then connect it to the K-sampler. And then for my text prompt, I'll put in my positive prompt, my negative prompt into the model conditioning, and then pass those along to the K-sampler here. And then for the latent image, our node here is converting our image into the latent space so we can get rid of this empty latent image. And then the VAE will pass through here, as well as the original image, and then finally the mask. So for the text prompt, you're basically describing what the image currently is and what you want it to be. So I will just simply say a woman wearing glasses. Now before I cue the prompt, I'm just going to make a few changes to the K-sampler. I'm just going to use a fixed value, because I find that a little easier for testing. Turn down the CFG to 5, change it from Euler to DPM plus 2M and Keras, as that's what is recommended for this particular checkpoint that I'm using today. And then click Cue Prompt. So first, while this is processing, let's take a look at that mask. So as you can see, it's a much softer mask. It's not a harsh black and white image. This is the big change with differential diffusion, is that it will look at each of these pixels or each of this on a per pixel basis for a much smoother result. So let's go ahead and review the output here. And as we can see, it looks really good. There is no lines from the original masked image to what has been inpainted with this image. Now, one of the things that you have to watch out for with soft inpainting, and this is a subtle thing, but since that mask has been blurred on the edges, we can see here that the original subject had a nose ring here, and it was right on the edge of the mask, whereas here we can see that that nose ring is completely gone. So you might want to change the size of the mask in this case, or kind of turn down the blurring of the edges a little bit to kind of reduce that if you don't want it in your final image, if you're seeing some of those details lost. But everything else though, this image looks much better than what we were getting previously through a basic inpainting workflow. So if you want to download this workflow, you can find a link to it in the description. And if you have any questions, drop it in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.